machine. Basically, when you look inside of a water structuring device on the table out here, what you'll see is you'll see two spheres, and as the water, I mean, as you would go deeper, you would see them in a DNA configuration. That's the way they're stacked, just like a DNA, just like the structure that we are. As water starts to turn, and we'll get into this more, but it's perfectly balanced. It's perfectly balanced in right spin and left spin. Left spin is feminine and creation energy, creative. Right spin is destructive energy, but it's absolutely essential for the balance of life. So, anyway, moving on. It's also hydrating. Dynamically harmonized water is hydrating. It's easily absorbed into the cells without effort. As water is in those turns initially, the water has the innate, or let's say the special ability to erase or neutralize all the toxins, all the memory of all the toxins that it's holding on to. And as it does that, it creates a dynamically harmonized space, creating a very energetically charged signature. And that energetically charged signature is what raises your potential. It gives your immune system a massive dose of energy. As we move on, dynamically harmonized water is also health in liquid form. Again, going back to hydrating and health, the majority of the population of the world are dehydrated, even though they consume massive amounts of water. That dehydration comes from, again, back to the water molecules are clustered in huge clusters. And it used to be a person at the age of 50 that the amount of energy that their body would have to produce in order to make bottled water or any water that you drink hydrating, to hydrate your cells, was enormous. Today that age is around 30. And it means that what we're facing is a great deal more toxins in the air we breathe, toxins in virtually everything, probably in the food we eat, water we drink, everywhere we go. So what this water has the potential of is increasing your immune system, increasing your ability to ward off disease. Anyway, dynamic and harmonized water also is a moving process. Just as you are a process in discovery and change, constantly evolving. So when you talk about dynamic is movement. And as long as we have movement in our life, we are enlivened, we are very energetic. It's the same way with water. It's very enlivened, very energetic. I used to sing a song, alive, awake, alert, enthusiastic. This is how I choose to start my day. That's the way water is, and especially coming out of nature, coming through dynamically harmonizing through a structuring unit, it's dancing. And it's very energizing, very enlivening, very awakening. And it's, in from our perspective, the way to go, the way to be. So this water is primarily, and as all water, to be used at the point of contact. We have shower units that bring that to you directly. We have all kinds of ways of shower units, portable units, etc. So, did that work? Okay. Natural action structured water. That we are? Yeah. It is. It forms when it is moving through the device. As it moves through the device, it creates a form of 5 to 20 molecules per cluster. It's organized in flowing geometric shapes rather than a more random number of molecules moving in a disordered fashion. So when you have a bag of marbles, for instance, and they're all the same size, you get more marbles in the bag. If they're all different sizes, you have gaps, you have spaces. You don't get as much in there. So depending upon the pressure that the water is moving through a structuring unit, if you pour it through, the water clusters are about 20 molecules per cluster. And yet, at that rate, it's very significant, the energy that it provides for you as you consume the water, or virtually any liquid that you consume. We can get into geometric shapes, and I'll get to that later. It's coming up here shortly. Okay. Natural action structured water creates a lower surface tension, so it can easily be absorbed by the cells of your body. As again, this water moves into the first turn, it creates a harmonization that brings about decreasing the surface tension of the water. Surface tension is measured in dynes, D-Y-N-E-S. And if the surface tension is high, again, your body has to bring that level down to 46 dynes or lower to make the water usable or hydration to the cells. So again, depending upon the surface tension, the amount of energy that your body has to expend in order to make the water usable can be extreme. And so, if as we want to be more energetic and more healthy, the lower the surface tension. One of the things we do to lower surface tension is we heat the water. It lowers the water by heating it. It lowers the water to about 54 dynes, somewhere in that area. And if you consider our body temperature being 98.6, that's where it takes it. What actually, it's a combination of energies that create a lower surface tension. One of the biggest ones being your heart. Your heart is a vortex, a dual vortex system. It spins the water to the left and to the right, exactly the way natural action structured water spins the water. So the liquid within you is dynamically harmonized. However, it's stressed by the tension that you accumulate through stress, through your normal daily routine.